So, you want to be an it girl? All right. Hi, guys, and welcome back to the show. Today, we are joined by Cassidy. Cassidy, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm so excited to be here.
Oh, my gosh. I'm so excited to have you. I have seen you all over TikTok and Instagram just making these like great little health swaps. So I definitely want to get all into that. But before we get into that, when people like ask you the scary question, in my opinion, they're like, so like, what is it that you do? Like in that annoying, exact annoying voice, like, what do you say to those people?
So I usually say, I'm just like a content creator and influencer. And the way I explain it to people is I create content and promote it to my audience and brands and different like hotels or services will pay me or give me a complimentary service or product in return. And I also create custom content for brands to use for their own marketing or ad purposes that I wouldn't post on my channel. But yeah, there's that question comes up all the time. There's people who are like asking it in just a rude way or people who just really have no idea what it is.
Right. Like I always like Uncle Jerry, you know, who's 74, doesn't quite get it. Like we get it when you're like, oh, like I'm a content creator, I'm an influencer. Totally get it. But I've always, you know, just felt like even I'm an actor. So even being like, oh, I'm like pursuing an acting career. Like people are like, oh, what show have you been on? And I'm like, it's not that simple. And people have these like crazy expectations. So I just always like to start off asking about, you know, what do you say? So
exactly. I mean that it comes up all the time and like social media influencers, content creators, it's such like a new topic for people who weren't like growing up in the same age. So I feel like it's important for people to like spread awareness about it and not just give it like the vague influencer term or I don't know what else you want to call it. I say influencer because it's more widely known, but it's not just like posting pictures and getting paid. Like there's a lot that goes into it that I think it's important to talk more about.
Yes. Oh my gosh. Well, you brought us right where I wanted to go. Tell us about kind of like what is your daily like look like having this job? And then also like, can you tell us a little bit about like, you kind of have like your own niches and how did you find those as well?
So to cover the niche thing, I couldn't find one thing because I love everything. Like I love traveling. I love health and wellness, holistic wellness, meditation, fitness, food. So when I was like looking into content creation and people say you have to choose one thing, I was like, there is absolutely no way I'm choosing one thing to talk about. Like I'm very like, I don't even know what it's called. Like I'm just a well-rounded kind of gal. So I figured what I would do is base it around lifestyle, we call it. And I cover everything from health and wellness to fashion to fitness. And then I have a separate account that just specializes in like fitness and health. And I also have like a fitness app. So I made it a little more like for myself, it was more organized because it's like, this is where all my fitness content is. This is my lifestyle. I kind of talk about everything, but the way that I go about it, lifestyle, because instead of it being like all over the place, maybe I'll be on vacation, like at a super cute resort and I'll post a picture in like something from Fashion Nova, for instance. But in my caption, I'll talk about how to stay healthy on vacation. So I try to tie everything in together because I had to figure out a way to make it work.
Yeah. And it's also really authentic to you if these are like all your true interests and what you want to do. Like, yeah, it's so weird. I feel like I've heard a lot of people on the podcast talk about being in a niche. And then also like, we're already kind of all sick of it. Like everybody was all like, oh, be one thing. And I'm like, I don't know. It's very interesting. So then can you break down for us kind of like what your daily looks like?
Yes. So it's different day to day, depending on like what campaigns I have going on or vice versa. So I usually, well, I always write a to-do list because I don't know how I could survive without one.
Amen.
I feel like I can get like at least five more things done, checked off my list if I write it down. Instead, if I just like keep it in my head, I get nothing done. So I wake up and have like a little morning routine, and I'm not going to tell you like, oh, I drink my water, meditate, like something. So like my, as ideal as that would be, it changes all the time. Sometimes I'll be able to meditate in the morning and have like a perfect breakfast. Other times I'll just wake up and like run out of the house. So I try to set realistic goals for myself, and I like to always start with some form of gratitude, and I talk to my crystals like a weirdo, but that's just something that keeps me grounded and starts my day off with intention. And then as for like the content and everything, I usually write my to-do list like and batch it. So one day I'll focus solely on like content creation, and I'll get my hair done because I'm not looking perfect every single day. So on the days that I want to create content, I'll like get my hair done and then shoot a bunch of content for different campaigns on that day. Another day I might focus on editing. And then now that I'm coming out with my new fitness plan, I've been setting a whole day aside to do stuff for the fitness app, because it's a lot easier for me to get things done when I batch it out like that.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's a lot of times I find myself working a little bit on this, a little bit on that. Like I'm all over the place. And in the end, I can get so much more done if I just focus on that one thing for like a day or a couple of hours. So yeah, usually I'll get my content done for one day, work out. In the moment, if I think of like a TikTok or something, I'll make it. At night or in the morning, I'll reply to my emails. And then, yeah, it's different from day to day, really.
I love that though. I love how you're kind of keeping your like mainline focus, because I feel like you're keeping your focus really clear by doing that, by having like today is content day, today is editing day, like where you're not letting like a million other noise, which I love so much, because I think sometimes if you don't have a to-do list, you're just like, okay, well, whatever comes to me is what's going to happen. Yeah. It can lead to a lot of stress.
So much. Like I've definitely hit burnout in the past, and that's because I'm also a full-time student in college. And so it's like, I've been taking a lot on, but, and there was a point where I hit burnout, but I'm finally finding a balance and knowing like, just knowing how to flow and get through the day with purpose and intention. And even like, I'll always focus, my core focus of the day is my work, obviously, because it's all I think about. I love doing it. And I'm like, I have such a drive for success that it can't leave my mind, but I try to always take time out of the day to breathe and do something I love. Like every day I work out almost. Like today I wanted to take an off day because my body needs it. But in the shower, I'll listen to podcasts or something inspirational. I just find little time, like little parts of the day to do something that like makes me happy or spend time in nature.
I love that. You're somebody to me, and you really struck me this way. So I'm very excited to hear about what you have to say about this, who really promotes balance, like a healthy, true balance. Like even just like the swaps you suggest, you know, they're like, not like massive. They're not like, oh, give up like every processed sugar and every bad thing ever. They're like very easy, like switches. So like, talk about your relationship with like balance and how you found that.
Well, I found everything that makes me feel good through the bad, really. Like I had to put myself through like so much to find like what really works for me. And I just think balance is what keeps me sane and helps with my mental health, because too much of anything is bad for you and too little of anything is bad for you. So my goal was just to find a happy medium, because when people are promoting, not going to say a specific diet, but just like completely eliminate carbs, mm-hmm. or any kind of elimination diet, it's so unrealistic and like, it's not even sustainable. And in the long term, it really like ruins your metabolism. So I really try to gear my content towards balance and helping people understand that, like, you don't need to go full force with anything. It's actually healthier to find that balance. And like, for example, I'm obsessed with ice cream. I cannot go one night without ice cream. So I found Halo Top, which I've been eating like probably every night for 4 years. And I would say that's a bit excessive, but it makes me happy. Yeah. And the rest of my diet is, I've been trying to do a lot of non-processed foods and stay pretty clean. But like, I have my chocolate cravings, and I know everyone has the sweets craving. So why completely eliminate something if it's like an important aspect of your well-being? You know, I don't know.
Absolutely. So when did you get into like fitness, and how did these like swaps come to you? Is it from like trial and error, or just like learning to listen to yourself?
So I got into fitness after I ended my soccer career, which that's a whole nother story for another day. I had like a traumatic brain injury, almost died, was in a coma. It's a whole thing. But moral of the story is I decided to pursue fitness because I felt like there were so many things pointing me in that direction. If I continued to play soccer, my whole college career would be soccer. I would have no social life. I love to travel. So I was like, I'm just going to live like a very fitness driven, healthy lifestyle. And I believe that my calling, like my second chance at life, was given to me to help inspire other people to live a healthy lifestyle. So I was on this journey of excellence and self-exploration, I guess you can call it, to really find the best ways to help me achieve an overall well-being and then share with other people how I did. So every day, like, I've taken a nutrition class in college, and for like, nothing against like the education and everything, those institutions, I learn a lot in school, but the nutrition program didn't really teach me anything, and I think was a little bit outdated, if I'm being honest. Mm-hmm. So I use my own resources and go on like the cited articles and everything to do my own research and learn what's healthy, what fads are, or what diets are diet fads, mm-hmm. and all that stuff. And I also do everything trial and error. So if I'm helping someone like with their weight loss journey, I'm going to try things out and see what really works, do research to back it up, because I'm never going to lead someone in the wrong direction of just what I think. I'll always do research before I post anything on social media, before I tell anyone anything. And I also just share my own like general tips that I've learned, because you can be a nutrition coach or nutrition teacher, but if you don't practice it yourself, you don't really get a full understanding. So for like the food swaps and everything, mm-hmm. I've done a lot of research, like gut health, everything like that. And I've tried things myself. So it's kind of just a mix of my own personal experience and education.
Well, good for you. Like, that is so impressive that you take the time to do the research, because I feel like there is just, I mean, I've even had a full podcast episode talking about just how messy I think fitness has become. And like, you know, we scroll through TikTok or Instagram, or even just like go to a health food store and see a trend diet, and we automatically think it's the quick fix. And it's like, it's not the diet pills of the 80s, but it's like the quick fix now. And like, you know, we could be doing very serious damage to ourselves. Like, I've recently been going through not serious, but it was uncomfortable, not great, gut issue. And I found out it was from like all these horrible things I had done to myself in college. I was like, yeah. I completely messed up my metabolism and just gut lining, like a whole thing. And so it's just like, we need more people clearing the space of like what is actually truly healthy and what's we should know is unrealistically not healthy at all.
And it's so misleading, like the way food is marketed, they actually don't have any regulations on what they can put on the package. So if it says like weight loss supplement or does this, does that. Like, they're allowed to put whatever they want, like any claims. They're like in the nutrition, on the nutrition label and everything, things are different and the ingredients, but a lot of people aren't reading the ingredients that are in the foods and they're just looking at the label on the front. So there's so many misleading products out there that even like I've been fooled plenty of times.
Right. I mean, it's not hard when it's literally all we are inundated. Can you tell us about not drinking coffee on an empty stomach? Because this was a big one that I've fucked up.
Everyone does. Like, because everyone promotes it being like a good thing, especially with intermittent fasting or whatever it is that people are doing these days, something new every week. But coffee is very acidic, so it's hard for you to digest already. And in general, it's not really good for your gut because it really increases your cortisol levels and can cause a hormonal imbalance. But there's a lot of foods out there. It's not something to take out of your diet. It's just make sure you're drinking at the right time. When you have it on an empty stomach, there's nothing that's like absorbing it really. And it's going straight into your gut or your intestines. And that puts a lot of stress on your gut. So, and it raises your cortisol. There's a lot of things that come with drinking coffee on an empty stomach. So for those people who are like, I'm not hungry in the mornings, or I like having my coffee first thing in the morning. Mm-hmm. Something I always suggest is kind of like balancing it out with either like grass-fed butter or coconut oil, some kind of fat to just lessen the effects of it because it's already so harsh on your body. First thing in the morning, your body's in a completely different place and you are breaking your fast like with breakfast. So the last thing you want to do is have a bunch of caffeine and all that stuff.
Love that. Yeah. It definitely was a huge part of my gut problems. And also like I had such a bad gut issue that I had to stop drinking coffee completely for 2 months. I was so traumatized that I did anyways, there was no problem. And I've been drinking it so much less. And like, I have seriously noticed my overarching stress has gone down way more because I'm not messing with my cortisol. It's mind blowing. I'm like, what was I doing?
The amount of coffee that people drink on a day-to-day basis, no judgment because like I have those moments, but it could be like so detrimental to your health. And a good way to balance it as well, like if you're like strong enough to get off of the coffee, everyone knows I love matcha. Like matcha lattes are my life with almond milk. Oh, I'm obsessed. And it doesn't give you the jitters. Like I totally get the jitters from coffee and I'm always like have that angst. And then I think of all the things I have to do, but I can't like organize it in my mind. It's like, yeah, I love the energy, but what do I do with it? And something I learned about coffee, and yes, matcha has caffeine, but it's a different kind because it has L-theanine, which has a calming effect. But something I learned about coffee that completely blew my mind is that when you drink coffee and get that energy, what it actually is doing is taking the energy that your body stores for the day and just giving it to you in that moment. So that's why you crash. It takes the energy that's like for the rest of the day and it just gives it to you then. That freaking blew my mind. But
that blows my mind.
I haven't looked at Yerbamate, but people have said that that's a better alternative to regular coffee. And I'm also a huge fan of mushroom coffee or chaga. And I just love matcha. So those are like my other recommendations if you want to get off your coffee kick. But I mean, if coffee is just like your jam, totally enjoy it. Just not first thing in the morning on an empty stomach.
Oh my gosh. I love that and hate it at the same time because it makes so much sense, you know, because you're kind of like I use this for mental health and physical health, but you're kind of like a battery. And if you are, you know, supercharging the battery and you're on your phone so much, it dies. That's like what it's like being on coffee. It's like,
exactly.
That's all out.
That's such a good analogy.
Oh, and you have to, and like, we are all about maintaining the like battery length here because we have a lot of shit to do. We all, everyone does. Like there's so much. Yeah. That being said, I have one more. I'm just dying to ask you. If you don't know this, no worries. But I saw one about, you were like, you can eat Lucky Charms after working out. And I like laughed my butt off. And I'm like, what is up with that?
Well, first of all, warning, someone commented and said there's like some lawsuit against Lucky Charms because they have something in them. But it wasn't like Lucky Charms specifically. I'm just saying like sugary foods are actually the best time to eat sugary foods are after workout, and it's actually beneficial for you to see like gym gains, because what it is a simple carb which converts directly to sugar. Whereas, first of all, let me clear this. When people say carbs are bad, they're associating carbs with cereal, bread, pizza, pasta, and that's a different type of carb. Those are simple carbs that we actually like after a workout, but those are converted directly into sugar. There's a different group, complex carbs, which is oatmeal, quinoa, foods like that, that take a longer time to metabolize, and they just work completely differently. But after a workout, when you have the glucose going directly like into your system, that helps replenish your muscles, restore your energy, and help you really see results. So it's just funny. People, if you've ever been to an LA Fitness or one of those gyms, they have those Tootsie Rolls on your way out. I love Tootsie Rolls. Or those sugar sticks, anything like that. It's because you want to have sugar directly after, so you can just replenish all of your muscles and glycogen restore glycogen levels, all that stuff. But there are specific sugars that you want to look for, where glucose, or I think that are fructose based. I might be wrong with the name, but I know that it's sugar. Gummy bears, like pixie sticks, those kind of candies, and really any food that you would like not want to eat to be healthy, you can have directly after a workout. So rice cakes, soft pretzels, those are more examples. That's like, it's insane because it literally helped me, and my boyfriend taught me this. It helps us see so much more gains because your muscles are able to recover so much quicker.
And that's why we should not believe everything everybody ever always tells us, because I like would never think that. I would never be like, and I love a soft pretzel. Some days I think I shouldn't eat gluten.
Because I'm from Philly, honey.
Yeah, like, I love a soft pretzel. If I could eat a soft pretzel, I am like one happy human. So like,
yes.
More power to you. And like, I mean, I just think it goes back to this whole notion that I've had recently with like fitness in general, is like, there are so many rules and then there's no rules at all. And everything's right and nothing's right. And it's like, at the same time, it's like, you just have to enjoy your life and like, you know, obviously like put in the work. Like you can't eat a pretzel for breakfast, lunch, and dinner and not get out of your office chair and like expect to have like the body you want to have, but like you can't not like have one pretzel a day and like whatnot. It's just so messy to me. So I love to hear these cool, like
there's so many things like they say, don't eat this or only eat this or just have green juice, which is a whole another topic. But
oh my God, if you need to go on a tangent about green juice, by all means, debunk it.
Green juice is great. Like all juices, I don't want to say they're great, but they taste good. But if you really want the nutrients, when you have like juices or go on juice cleanse, first of all, juice cleanses are a hoax. Just like don't even try them. They like, just don't. But what happens when you just juice like a fruit, not as much for the vegetables, like, but when you do fruit juice cleansing, all that's happening is you're taking all the nutrients out of the fruit. And what the only thing that's left is the glucose. So you're pretty much just digesting the sugars and you don't really get any benefits from that. So my boyfriend, I got him the most bougie blender. I think it's like one of the commercial ones. It's called the Silent One.
Yes,
I think it's a Vitamix.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. He makes a smoothie every morning. So smoothies are fine. And juices, like, there are some benefits still, but it kind of defeats the purpose of like getting the nutrients. Mm. So yeah.
I love that. Yeah. Cause I think everybody remember when celery juice was like the biggest fad, like it was just like eat, drink, live celery juice. It was also, I'm sorry. I like was into it. I was like, yeah, I'll drink celery. It's gross. Like it's awful.
I think there's people with different taste buds. I was talking to my friend about this the other day. For me, celery is so bitter, but for other people, it tastes like nothing. And then we were comparing it to like cilantro. For some, cilantro tastes like soap. Other people, it tastes fine. Like for me, cilantro tastes amazing, but like I'm that person with celery. It's so bitter and like tangy. I don't even know how to explain it. It's so hard to.
And what nutrients are we getting out of celery juice? Probably none. Like,
yeah, it's
another crazy. One is coconut. My mom can't, she can't stand coconut. She says it tastes like soap and I love coconut. So I don't know. Weird food for thought on taste bud. Okay. Slight pivot, but I'm going to get real, real with you. You look absolutely fantastic. Like your body is killer, but you really like, you do put in the work, but there is so much out there, especially I feel like with social media of like pressure to look a certain way. And it used to even be worse. Like when we were growing up, it was like stick skinny, not even a stick, not even a fit skinny. How do you maneuver through like the healthy body, like world and like, you know, stay in a fitness place, but not get into any like toxicness?
I mean, I've definitely caught myself in moments like in a toxic state. Like I haven't talked to any medical professional, but I think I have body dysmorphia because I'm telling you, when I look in the mirror, I have no idea what I look like.
Oh girl.
That can be body dysmorphia or just the fact like when you look in the mirror every day, nobody, like you can't really see progress unless you look at like a picture from 6 months. That's why I think progress pics for people who follow my fitness plan are so important. But yeah, like when I look at myself in the mirror, I'm like, I don't know, do I have to change anything? Like I have no idea how I look. I have to look at like pictures or something. But yeah, the social pressure never really got to me. But recently, like as I've grown my following, the pressure's on. Like I want to be at the top. I want to be a top creator. And like it's all about social media influencers, more brand deals, like, or the more you stand out, the more brand deals you get, the more money you make. So it's, what do I have to do to get to the top? And then it gets to a point where you do have to compare yourself to others to like get a gauge on what you're doing wrong or what you're doing right. Something that's helped me succeed is seeing what works for creators who are more successful, or even, this is a common thing that's known in the industry, not frowned upon. Like you just, even Charlie D'Amelio, like you have to copy the trends of what's already trending. So if I see a viral video of a fitness girl that went, like it did really well, I'll recreate it with my own twist. But as you do these things, like you catch yourself sometimes comparing yourself. And what I do is just, I honestly, like I'm not, it sounds cliche, but I honestly do it. Like I spend time in nature or do like some form of self-care, like meditate or get a massage or just like spend time with my boyfriend or like whatever it is that I do, listen to a podcast, walk on the beach, some kind of grounding exercise to just remember my purpose, like remember why I'm here and remember like what little of the space I take up in a big world. Like, why would I worry about something so small when I have an entire life to live? I probably won't think about this in a year. And the best I could do is be the best version of myself. So at the end of the day, all you have is yourself. Not to like do a whole speech here, but why worry about someone else when like you're you can be the best version of you. And it's easier to say than do. And I get caught in that a lot, but it's important to take time to always ground yourself and remember your purpose. And some people haven't even found their purpose yet. So you need to take time for self-discovery and to look inward and know who you are and what you stand for. Because if you're always spending time like with friends and not ever focusing on yourself, when you get to these like lows in life, you won't know what to do because you don't fully understand yourself. So
no. And yes, that is completely kind of the idea of the title of the podcast, like Confessions of a Wannabe It Girl. Like we can all acknowledge the excess and like go for it. But sometimes like we do have to remove ourselves and just like find whatever it is to pull yourself out and be grounded. And so like, I don't think it's cliche at all. And I love hearing like, you know, that you take time for self-care and like whatnot. It's not talked about enough, like in the scroll of social media. Like it is because it's like in reels, but it's not really in reels. That's something we're never going to be able to see online because it's very personal to each person. So like, I love that. And like, you know, I've also come to realize this is a very new idea in my head, so let's see how this one comes out. That successful people like have to have like hardcore off time, because if you're always on 100-120% of the time, like there's nothing left to give in any place. Like you're already, like we were talking about with the phone, spent. So like, I love that. And you were just so honest talking about like the comparison game. And it's just like, I think it's so important. So thank you for saying that.
Yeah, I think a lot of times I'll always, because social media as a content creator, you don't have days off. It's not like, oh, I'm off on Saturday. I'm on 1 a.m. My boyfriend's on his job. He's like, oh, wait, like you're not done? No, you have to be thinking of the next trending piece of content, and it gets overwhelming. Sometimes I find myself always trying to think of something or the next trend, but right now I'm at this park, and this is a place where I feel like I can really ground myself and just take time alone. I go to the dock and just like, I'm a water sign, so I sit on the dock and watch the dolphins because there's always dolphins here in Charleston, and they're like my spirit animal. But it gives me time to just think, and something that people really like don't think about is taking time to think. And I'm not talking about it as in like overthink, think of the next trend, the next piece of content. Just like think about what your goals are, what you are grateful for, like what your purpose is. Having that time alone really encourages inspiration. And when I find myself like, I don't know, what do they call it? Like in a brain freeze.
Oh my God. A brain freeze, a freak out. I call it a tailspin. Oh my God. Going down the rabbit hole of your own brain. We all know that feeling.
Whatever it is, or like, however you think of it, or to think of it too much, I don't even know. When I can't think of content to create or whatever, and I run myself crazy because I'm like, oh, I can't think of anything, I take the time for peace and quiet. And these ideas come to me because I'll be like inspired while I'm watching the dolphins. I'll think, oh, maybe I'll do a video about grounding, or I'll be on vacation, enjoying my fish, my freshly caught fish. I just got back from Cabo, and I had this fish that was indigenous called tichuaba. Oh my God. But that's like another story. But anyways, that inspires me to do a TikTok about how to eat healthy on vacation, like little tricks to use. I posted something like that. But sometimes, well, most of the times you think of the things like while you're living in the moment. So, I try to remind myself to be present because that's when my greatest ideas come to me.
Love that. Little bit of a pivot again. So you have a new fitness plan app. Tell us about it. Like, what's it going to be like?
So I have this app. I work with these app developers to come out with my own fitness plans, all personalized. I pick and choose every single workout, every exercise, every plan, and I just post them on their app. But I have a bunch on there right now, I have Hourglass, Hourglass 2, Booty Building, Titan and Tone, a couple of others, but I curate all of these workouts specifically for like whatever your goals are. And I also encourage everyone to pay attention to their diet because that's literally 90%. So that's just given. I didn't include any recipes, although I have them on my Instagram. But I'm coming out with a hot girl summer plan.
Woo!
And it is 1 month long and you get 1 day off. So it's definitely a challenge, but it's not to go. What I'm not trying to do is encourage people to just like go all in, like how you take out carbs completely. But for this time, I want to encourage people, like, it's hot girl summer, time to leave him on red, like, boy bye, focus on you and your goals and become the greatest version of yourself in this short timeline to get into the habit, because it takes 28 days to form a habit. And by joining or engaging in something like this, you can train your brain, like, how to get into a habit, how to live healthier, and just become the best version of yourself.
See, and I love challenges like that because I feel like you do it for a certain amount of time. That's a stretch and it's hard. But then after you do it, you can just like be like, okay, so I don't have to be like this every single day, but like, what are the steps to being 1% better like every day that I can consistently stay in line with this experience I just had? It's like, yeah. It's a good like mental like and physical. Also, you feel so good when you like put yourself into a challenge and you've taken the time to complete it. Like your self-worth goes the fuck up because you're like, I took the time to do that. So I love that. I'm so excited for this to come out.
Sorry to interrupt. Finish like a challenge, it's the best feeling. Like it really is just like such a good feeling. And it's also, this challenge is kind of like giving yourself a reset. You get a little taste of what it's like to be like fitness junkie AF. And then you can take what you want from it. Like maybe now I'll do 5 days on, but you'll feel better. You'll like understand what it's like to be in a routine. And we also have some new features on the app that there's a group chat. So you'll be a part of a community of women, men, they can join too, who are just trying to become the best version of themselves, and we'll be inspiring each other, sharing recipes, anything. But it's just the first step of changing your life. The first step you could do is take the first step.
Yes. So to wrap us out, what is your message you hope to share with your followers? And this sounds a tidbit cheesy, but like the world as well. What would you say your message is?
I've said this before on like social media and everything, but I really stand by it. Like, don't take life so serious. It's so important to just live, like express yourself, live unapologetically yourself, and explore life. And not just like when you're talking to people, I talk to everyone like I talk to anyone. I'm just myself. I don't have to change myself if I'm talking to a certain person. Like, just be yourself and people will love you for that. Like when you're just unapologetically yourself, that's the best thing you can do. And you will be the happiest, because at the end of the day, like, life is not that serious. These things, like, we're all people that experience similar things on a day-to-day basis. You don't have to put so much pressure on yourself in different like social situations or life situations. I don't know how to like word it, but just enjoy the ride. Like, calm down, take a breath, and appreciate what you have, and realize like we're all here just doing our best. Like, it's not that serious.
I love that. Cassidy, thank you so much for coming on the podcast. Please tell everybody where we can find you at.
Thank you so much. This was such a great opportunity and I'm so glad I got to meet you. You guys have to stay tuned with Confessions of a Wannabe It Girl. And you can find me on Instagram at Cassidy Kometz, also at Cassidy Morgan Fitness, YouTube at Cassidy Kometz, TikTok at Cassidy Kometz, and you can find my fitness app in my bio on all of those things except for YouTube. So thank you so much for having me.
Oh my God, of course.
Pleasure.
Girl, I'm so excited to see where you go. Thank you guys so much for listening. We'll see you next week.
Thank you.